Welcome back to the Gentleman's Gazette and our series, Taking It Apart, where we cut open products to see what materials were used, what are the things you can't see from the outside, and to examine the level of craftsmanship. Ultimately, by doing so, we'll help you not having to waste your money on a product that's not worth it. Now, it's always easy to complain about other people's products and saying they're not quality, so I decided to cut open a Fort Belvedere wallet, which I designed, and I know what's in it, and so I can show you all the details and the thought that went into it when producing it. Very first wallet, actually, that I got, I still have to this day. It's from the very early days of Fort Belvedere. It's made of a deerskin leather, and I'm still wearing it because I want to see how long it lasts before it wears out. Now, I'm not going to be cutting this one apart, but fortunately, we sometimes get returns, such as this wallet here, for example. I mean, take a closer look, right? Someone probably maybe had it in their back pocket and fell off a bike or a motorcycle and really damaged the leather, and they just complained and said, hey, your wallet is not of good quality, and we took it back and gave them a replacement. So I hope after this video we're not going to get a whole bunch of people just complaining about regular wear and tear. But yeah, I mean, it's a perfect candidate to be just taken apart. I have a few different wallets here. I'm going to be starting with our deerskin wallets, which are made from Scandinavian rawhides. And then I'll take another one apart, which is our calf leather wallets, which is a leather that comes from Italy. They're also lined sometimes either with deerskin or lined like the black and red one, with calf inside and out. First of all, what's kind of special about these Fort Belvedere wallets is that they have folded edges in both ways. If you look at regular wallets, typically what happens, they fold an edge and sew it down and that's it. And when making wallets, I wanted to make something special, and so I decided that we wanted this folded edge, which is something you rarely see in leather goods these days anymore, because you really have to thin out the edges so it doesn't bulge up or bunch up, but is flat and even. So from the outset, to the untrained eye, it may not seem like anything special, but once you actually get into it, it's a lot more difficult. So let's dive right in here, taking like a sharp knife here, cutting things apart, and I don't have to be super careful because I know I will be not using this wallet anymore. It's really just there to show you what's inside. So I'm carefully cutting through these seams here, and you can see there's a bit of glue residue that helps to make sure the leather doesn't move once you actually sew it together. These stitches here are machine stitches. They're not hand stitches. It would take an awful lot of time to do it by hand. I mean, it could be done, but the wallet would be a lot more expensive that way. And also you wouldn't get this great regularity of the stitches. And I know some people argue that, you know, everything handmade is inherently better. I don't always agree. What I agree with is that handmade stuff generally takes a lot longer to make simply because a lot more goes into it. So this is the backing now, as you can see. You can see here the edges of the outer leather were folded over, and I'm be cutting those apart here now. They were folded and then sewn. When you touch it, they don't stand up much, which means they had to be thinned out carefully before being sewn and folded over. It's kind of hard to tell. And then here at the corners, they also have to be thinned out and folded nicely, because you have multiple layers of leather being on top of each other. And you can see it's all glued down, so it actually is pretty easy to put together and fold. As I'm cutting the edge here, you can see I'm taking it apart here now. I'm also taking part of the lining leather, because that's what was there. When designing the leather or the wallet, it's really important to me that everything in here was leather. Most wallets that you find these days skimp. And sometimes you find cardboard on the inside or other cheaper materials like a leather fiber product that is basically just leather scraps pressed together in a way. I wanted something that was completely all leather because I like the touch of leather. I like the feel of it. And it's just very, very nice. Also, I wanted an interlining that helped keep things in shape without being too hard over time. So you want something that you can bend that doesn't leave creases. And that's what we did here. Now it helps that we were working together with a family that has been making fine leather goods for over 200 years. So as you can see here, this outer shell is just a piece of deerskin leather. The edges are finely skived and thinned out, so when they're folded on both sides, they don't really stand up. So before you cut this, all the edges have to be finely thinned out, otherwise it's not going to work. The interlinings, you can see the corners are cut, so there's not any extra. Then they're nicely folded together. So we got it here. This is basically the inside of the wallet. This was one part of the lining, which typically is made of a relatively inexpensive fabric that is thin. I wanted something that was leather, but you can see if you touch this leather, this is a lot thicker than this one. Because with a wallet, you don't want something that's so big in your pocket that with the cards inside, it's just uncomfortable to hold. Continuing to cutting it apart, here you can see things were folded over at the edges, which is important because in here, you see these are the card slots, right? And in order for them to be relatively flat and not just bunching up, you really have to, again, thin things out. Otherwise, they will look terrible in the finished wallet. I think wallets or anything in fine leather, menswear or leather goods, requires a lot more attention to detail. Oftentimes you can find these relatively rugged wallets where you know they have open cut edges. They're made out of thick, like saddle style leather or something from Horween. And it's a good product, it lasts for a while, but it's just not as refined. So here you can see what happened. This was the original divider. So you could have maybe euros and dollars or different currencies or one for receipts, one for money. And this divider is also leather and that's very thin, just like the lining. So it doesn't add bulk. At the same time, it's much more durable than any fabric. And again, the whole leather part is just a lot nicer. So I'll take this apart here. I'm almost ripping the leather. And you can see these individual pieces that are all folded over and cut by hand for the individual card slots. Now I'll cut the seam down here. You can see the wallet, basically in a regular wallet, down here, right? This is the part we're at right now. This is this area, and you have the other leather, the contrast leather, being folded over. This is what you see on the inside here now. Taking it apart, folding it over. Making sure the glue is not interfering. And the corners nicely folded so they don't bunch up in an ugly manner. Again, central layer and lining. Lining center divider. At the top here, it was again thinned out and then folded over and glued. So at the top, you don't have a rough edge, but again, a nice folded edge that doesn't wear out as easily. And also, it is just the same texture as the leather in the front. So I just like that little detail. It's not just a cut edge, but a folded edge. As we know, we do the same things with our belts, just because it's a higher level of workmanship, and I like that in a product. So now here, these are basically the card compartments, and you can see they're attached at the top. So I'm going to cut these threads here. You can see on this side here, they added a strip of leather. They didn't cover the entire layer. It's just in the visible middle. Why? Again, we don't want to make it too thick. Now in the back here, you see there's a fabric. It's a very nice cotton fabric that's extremely thin. It's specifically made for wallets, so the card slots don't end up and get thick, because if you have each individual layer in the back added with leather, which is something we tried initially, it just looks terrible and it gets really big and fat. Whoa, really big and fat.
But my stomach don't feel so good. Yeah.
Then we try to really make the leather as thin as possible, but at that point, it's just not stable enough anymore, but the cotton still has a nice flexibility. So again, it's great to work with people who have done something for hundreds of years and gained that knowledge from their parents and grandparents. So you don't have to just do all kinds of trial and error to get things the way you want them to be. Cutting it off here on the back side, loosening the threads. Okay. These are pretty nice. Holder layers, so to speak. So you can see down here, it's lined with a cotton from both sides. Down here is the Fort Belvedere logo that's backed. And then the card layers are lined with this cotton, so it's not too big, but on top, you still have all leather, so it looks like a nice all leather wallet. Edges on top are folded, and you can see a little iron here was used to create that little kind of impression, which makes it look neater and super finished. Then they're all folded and just glued, and I can cut it up here, but there's nothing really in there. Yeah, that's just the way it is. Just a cotton cut and then the leather glued onto and folded over. As I'm going with the leather here, you can see I'm cutting it, and you can see how it's aniline dyed, and dyed all the way through. The finishing being slightly darker, but it's typical because you have different finishes on top. So these are the individual compartments, and they're all the same basically, right? It's always a piece of cotton with the leather on top. Voila. You can see all these stitch rows here in the back. so it's all held in place together so it doesn't move around and the cards don't go too far down. We'll have the other side here, which is pretty much exactly the same. I have to cut it open here. And you can see back here, it's handwork, right? It's not like a machine pre-cut. These are all actually cut individually by hand, which for leather is nice because leather is not identical. It's a natural product. It's from a natural hide or skin, an animal. And so there are always irregularities. And someone who's into leather and able to cut it can see, oh, this is a little stretchy here. Oh, here I have to move a little bit because this is not the highest quality part, but the other part is. And I want that. Haven't cut those stitches up here yet. Great. Okay. So now here, last but not least, that's like the final layer here. It's glued together. You can see this piece leather too here is extremely thin, just so it doesn't add a lot of bulk. This is the other part. Deer skin is just a nice durable leather that has this characteristic creasing, but it is very different than the calf leather. The calf leather is a little stiffer, and this one in particular, as you can see, has a nice effect when the light shines on it, and that's achieved by the top here. You see the leather has a light brown color, but this is a lot darker brown. So whenever you want this effect where you feel like you can look inside the leather, you want a lighter color underneath and something darker on top that in certain spots allows to just look deeper inside of it. If you have an aniline dyed leather in brown, if it was the same color or pretty much the same at the bottom and the top, it would be much harder to get this desired effect. All right, so here we have the outer shell, which is this calf leather, Italian calf leather. You can really see the lighter spots that you need for this kind of effect that you get on the leather. Otherwise, the lining is all a deerskin leather. If you look at the edges here, where they're folded, you can just unfold them. Top here. Okay. Putting the button back on so we're not getting any chest hair comments. Oh well, I'm sure they'll come. It's all open here now. And then here, take that apart again. Here you can see beautiful color. The interlining. You can see it's just attached at the edges, not in the center, because when you have two layers of leather, basically this outer layer here has a longer distance than the inner layer, and if they were glued, there would be a certain tension. This way, they can still move in your wallet, in your back pocket of your pants, but it won't kind of wrinkle in a weird way. You can really see the opening here. It's just attached on the edges. Let's see, if I don't cut it, it's much harder to rip it apart. And don't stick together. So. Spray the backing card. Top part, all leather, individual compartment of the credit card slot. You need a special machine that you can get leather that thin and uniform because it's a skin. And let's see, it rips much more easily when you can access it that way. But since the edges are folded, once it's folded, you cannot get that initial cut and it's much more durable. So where the wallets made? These are made in Germany. Definitely not a low-cost country, but when we make these products, we look for people who really know what they're doing, where there is a tradition of the craftsmanship, and someone who is similarly obsessed with quality as we are. And if that means that product costs a little more, so be it. We'd rather do it right at a higher price than making a cheaper product that is not up to snuff. Man, these individual compartments, they look so easy from the front, but actually making them and folding all the edges is quite a bit of work. Let's see the credit card imprint here. It's hilarious. Yeah, look at that. That's an interesting way to get a credit card information from someone. You can see the leather is thinner there because we don't want to add any thickness, and it's backed by several layers, so it doesn't have to be as thick. This on the other end is a little thicker. And you can see from the creases, it develops this patina where you fold it this way. You can really see how the lighter color shines through the leather. And because it's a non-sanded leather, it's just a very nice look. It's finished with a wax, so it gets its shininess. But yeah, just a very cool calf leather, and I like the look.